गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर क्लास दैट इज मैनेजमेंट एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल बिहेवियर. लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ फॉर अ व्हाइल. माय नेम इज मोहम्मद आजम खान एंड फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स आई एम गोइंग टू टेक एमओबी सब्जेक्ट फॉर यू गाइस. या फर्स्ट वी विल गो विद अ स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय मैनेजमेंट? कैन एनीवन टेल मी हु विल To whom we call a manager, or what do you mean by management? Manager is a person who leads his team, or who control, or direct, or organize, or plan to take out the work from them is known as a manager. So, management is the art of getting things done through and with the people in formally organized groups. So what does it mean? Management means what? Taking out the work by other peoples, or with the help of other peoples, or with the help of other employees or subordinates, and work out in a formally organized group for an orientation goal, for getting the or for reaching towards the goal. Next one. Management is the process of designing, maintaining an environment in which individuals working together in group efficiently accomplish selected aims. And next, management, that means what in by management? It is a process of designing, not only taking out the work done by other people. Apart from that, we have to plan it. That means it is a process of designing and maintaining. We have to implement that also. What we are planning, we have to organize that, or we have to implement that, and creating such an environment in which individuals, or means our individual employees, are working together in groups. That means the group of people is working for a common goal or for a common project, and that to be an efficiently accomplished selected aims. Aims means here goals for achieving a common goal. So that is nothing but management. I repeat, management means what? It is a process of designing for a particular time period, or so and so time, or so and so date. Here we are going to complete this task, and within a short span of time, or within a quality way. And not only that, designing, we have to maintain, and we have to create such an environment in the organization where individual as well as a group of people work together for a common goal. For that common goal, it should have to be achieved. Now, another thing, management is that function of an enterprise which concerns itself with the direction and control of the various activities to attain the business objectives. Now, if you see here in the picture, organizational behavior, how the behavior should be there of an individual or a group of people for their common goal in the organization. That means we come to know about what mean by management, and now we will come to know that means organization behavior. How in an organization a group of people working together for the common goal. For example, in our college, if I take an example of faculty, all faculties are individuals and they are working in groups for the common goal. What is the common goal? To provide the quality of education to students of MBA, first year and second year students. This is the common example. So how we are planning? One by one subject teacher will upload the class, or they will take the class according to the scheduled time. One more example. If I take your own example or a company examples, how the people will organize. That means already they have to wake up early in the morning. If a manager want to go to his office, what does he do? He will plan himself. At so and so date and so and so time, I have to be there in the meeting. So what he will do? He will plan. I have to wake up early in this time, and I have to go for the walking or jogging. Then he will take his breakfast. Then he will get ready for coming to the office. After coming to the office again, he will open his laptop and he will prepare all his slideshows, PPTs, or whatever the things are, the work he should have to do, and he will get ready for his work. So all these things comes under the organizing, and how it should be behavior. Our behavior should be in a positive way. See, in the picture, you can see here clearly how the people are greeting with one and all. Secondly, they all are having the positive body language and gesture. If you come to the next thing, we will go with the introduction of the management. Management is a process of planning, organizing, directing, and controlling the organizational resources for attaining organizational goals. What does it mean? It means that, for example, we are running a manufacturing industry. Our product is biscuit. So, what is the main organization goal here? To take out the packets, I mean ready-made or finished goods of the biscuits packets in our organization. That is the main goal. What does it mean? What does it include? It includes planning, organizing, directing, how much raw materials are we need, when we have to deliver the product, what is the time duration, how many workers are there, are all the machines are working properly or not, is there any power consumption is there in the machine or not, either it is in a working day, very next day or not. All these things we have to plan in a sufficient way before starting the work or before completing the project. Now, once the manager has planned, then he will go for the organizing, implementing. He will give the work, he will divide the work with his subordinates, he will take the work with them in a proper way. So again, not only giving the work is important, he has to observe the work to whom he had given the work, either they are doing properly or not, in an effective way or not, or in time or not. So all these things will be organized. Now, directing, what he will do, he should have to direct. If something is going wrong, or if the employees are unable to understand, or if there are any errors, he should have to direct them. And control should be there, his command should be there, what the order he is giving, it should have to be followed by each and everyone to down his line. And he should have to plan the resources, how much resources do we have? He should have to plan towards the resources. What are the resources? Are the raw materials are there? He should have to organize. Either we have to order for the new raw material, or it is sufficient for us to fill up that. He should have to direct to his employees that how much skilled labors are there, and that to be the effective labors who can short out the work within these raw materials or resources. So within limited resources also, we can plan and we can work on it. So, F.W. Taylor is known as the father of scientific management. He contributes, investigated that the effective of use of human being in industrial organization. One more person by the name Henry Fayol was known as the father of modern management. So, all these things which we have done in the introductions, we are going to learn in depth in our upcoming slides in today's class. Now, next one is management as a process. What we are saying, the term process refers to a set of actions which are performed in a planned sequential order. Many management gurus or experts, here gurus means experts, considered management as a process because the different activities or the functions of management need to be performed in a required to be carried out in a sequential order or in a correct order. That is, the first activity is planning, followed by organizing, staffing, leading and controlling. These are also known as the functions of management organizations. What is the first thing? To manage anything, first we should have to understand what is my management. Management means what? Managing the task or managing the goal or fulfilling the requirement or managing to his team or leading. A leader, one is an individual who is going to lead his team. Next. Now, manager, one who leads and manages the team and organization, is known as a manager. Now, what are the functions of management? Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, coordinating, and decision making. We will learn one by one after the importance, scopes, and features of management. So now we'll go with the management process. What is the management process, or what are the functions of the management? First, it should have to plan. This is the planning should be there. Then directing should be there. Organizing should be there. Staffing should be there, and controlling should be there. So here, first, what do you mean by planning? Plan. Plan means what? Doing an action. That means planning means you have to plan. Plan for doing any kind of action. Before doing an action, we have to make a work, that is known as planning. Organizing. What we plan, we have to organize. And staffing. Staffing means what? To whom? That means what sort of employees are needed for our work. That means recruiting the peoples in a such a way. Next one, directing. That means first we have to understand that staffing means what? Staffing in the sense recruiting the right person for the right job at the right place. Directing means what? The manager should have to direct to his employees either what sort of problems or errors they are finding in future, either they are working properly or not. Control means he should have to have total control on that. Now, we'll go for the nature of management. What do you mean by nature of management here? The nature of management, it includes, first one is multidisciplinary tasks. So what do you mean by multidisciplinary? That means management drawn freely ideas and concepts from disciplines as psychology, sociology, anthropology, economics, ecology, statistics, history, etc. Management integrates the ideas and concepts taken from this discipline and present newer concept which can be put into practice for managing the organization. This is the multidisciplinary task and this is the nature of management. Next one is dynamic nature of principles. Principles means here rules and regulations. The principle being a fundamental truth which establishes causes and effect relationships of a function. The principles framed by the management are flexible in nature and changes with the change in the environment in which an organization exists. So what is happening? Once it will be fixed by the manager or the head of the department, and it will change only if it is in need of change by seeing the environment. Now, next one is relative. That means management is a relative, not absolute principle. So, management principles being relative, not absolute, should be applied according to the need of the organization in the light of prevailing conditions, thereby giving allowances for different changing environment. Now, management is a science and art. See, management is both, it's in science as well as it's an art. How it can be? Management is both science and art. Management uses both scientific knowledge, and art is managing an organization. Art means what? Managing and organizing the organization or the employees for a common goal. That is an art. It is working like that. So how it is can be scientific? It is giving some creativity. A knowledge is coming from that, and it is based on science. So what we are saying, science is based on logical consistencies, systematic explanations, critical evaluations, and experimental analysis. The process of management does involve the use of know-how and skills like any other art, such as music, painting, sculpture, etc. This is also an art, how the people should have to take out the work done by other peoples for achieving a common goal. Now, management as professional. See, profession means what? Is an occupation for which specialized knowledge, skill, and training are required, and the use of skills are not meant for self-satisfaction, but these are used for larger interests of the society, and success of these skills are measured not in terms of money alone. So what is happening here? That means you are having a professional, like a doctor is a professional in his work, a teacher is professional in his work, an engineer is a professional in his work, like that a manager is also, that means managing the things also is also in profession. You see, in the organization, managers will be there. In the banks, the manager will be there. What is work? He should have to manage his branch and his team. That's the reason we are saying management is as a profession. Now look at the last term, that is universality of management is a universal phenomenon. See, management is a universal phenomenon. Everyone knows that. Now, however, management principles are not universally applicable, but are to be modified according to the needs of the situations. So this was the nature of management. Some more nature of management, it includes universal process. Everywhere in the world it is working. It is in continuous process. See, if one person is working, if a manager has been changed or got promoted or got debarred from his work, the some other persons will come in and will continue the same process. It is intangible. Tangible means what we can see, touch, feel. But intangible means it is opposite to it. That means we can't touch it, but we can feel it, but we can realize that. Now, it is a social process. It is helpful for the society. It is an art as well as a science. It is a goal-oriented. That means management means what? Management is a process where it is used for reaching the goal. That means we are getting the oriented, result-oriented goal. Next, group activity. What will happen in the management? The group of people work together for a common goal. That's the reason we are saying it is as management means what? Group activity. Being creative. Something creative should be there. Creative means not innovating. Some new things or strategies or planning should have to be come out so that we can fulfill or reach to our goals within a small resource or within our capacity. Next, features of management. Here are the some features of management. What does it include? Management is a goal oriented. Yes, management is a distinct activity. And it is a process. Management is a social process. Management is a system of authority. Management is needed at all levels. Here, all levels means our top level, middle level, and low level. In our second unit, you are going to learn all these things. Principles of management are dynamic. Principles means here what? Rules and regulations are norms. N-O-R-M-S. Norms. Norms of management are dynamic. Group efforts. How it can be takes place? It is in group efforts. By showing you some slides in the upcoming slides, you can able to understand what are the features of management. Intangible and coordination force. It is influence behavior. Now, what is the importance of management? So, what are the main importance of management? Why management is need? Management is need. Because to meet the challenges of the change, to accomplishment of the group goals, effective utilization of business, effective functioning of the business, resource development, sound organization structure, management directs the organizations, integrates various interests, stability, innovation, coordination and team spirit, tackling problems means solving problems, tool for personality development. So this all overall the main concept or the importance of management is to run the organizations in a smooth and short way. See, what are the things are needed? It is a challenging task and it is a group goal. See, if I take an example of our college, ISL Engineering College, Salman sir is there. He is a person who is managing the all the requirements, all the organizations, I can say. He has divided the work since soundful management is there. Structure he has divided in such a way that the different departments are running in different places, A block or B block in different classes. Different people are utilizing different subjects and different skillful students are utilizing their skills in different ways. All these things are running. A single person is managing. He is dividing the work and is, that means he is planning the work and is organizing the work and is implementing and is staffing, is directing, is controlling all the work. So what does it mean? It means it is a, we are having a sound organization structure here. And what does it include? It includes stability is there. Innovation, some new thing, creativity will be there. So last time we have just celebrated our orientation program. So what does it include? Creativity is there. The students, they had bought some balloons and empty cups and they had make you play some games. Some creativity will be there, which is going to manage. Within time, we have managed within what we can say in a quality way, we have managed. All these things will come under the management. What are the functions of management? As we are saying, the planning, organizing, staffing, directing, control. See, the planning should be there and should have to plan to the staffing, and after giving the work to the staff, we should have to direct them whether they are, we have to check it whether they are doing properly or not. Then organizing, once we have started implementing, these directing people will go for this. Okay, first one, planning to staffing, and we have to control on it and we have to organize on that, and again it will be we have to direct to the students. Is it clear? I repeat, once we plan, we are giving this plan or keeping in front of our employees or the staffing. Then we are controlling them and we are organizing them and we are directing them. Again, if we found anything's problem, again we are planning it, replanning. So totally it is a chain. Now we'll go one by one. What does it include? What is the meaning and everything? What is the planning definition? Planning is what, according to the Knoots and O'Donnell. He says planning is deciding in advance what to do. That means planning is what? Deciding what to do in advance. Future course of an action is taking place. How to do it, when to do it, and who is to do it. Planning bridges the gap between where we care now and where we want to go. It makes possible things to occur which would not otherwise occur. According to the George Story, planning is the selecting and relating of facts and making and using of assumptions regarding the future in the visualization and formulation of proposed activities believed necessary to achieve desired results. So what he is saying, according to Knoots, he says that planning means doing in advance, are deciding in advance what to do, how to do, where to do, and by whom to do. And it makes the bridges, the gap between where we care now and where we want to go. That means where we are and where we have to be. But according to the George theory, he says that planning is what? It's a selecting and relating of facts and making using of assumptions. We have to select. According to the Knoots and O'Donnell, he says planning means what? Deciding in advance what to do, how to do it, when to do it, and who is to do it. So here in theory, he says that we have to in future, that means we have to visualize and we have to formulate of purpose activities believed necessary to achieve desired results. According to the James Stoner, he says planning is a process of establishing goals and a suitable course of action for achieving those goals. Now, we'll go with the organizing, our second functions of management. Like we have some introduction, organizing is a process of creating structure. It is deciding how best to group organizational activities and resources should have to be allocated or usage. Essential for performing staffing, directing, and controlling functions. Organizing means what, in simple parlance, what we plan, we are going to organize that. We are implementing those things. Now, what is staffing? See, staffing means what? The staffing function of management fulfills the need of the organization to find the right people for the right job. See, in the organization, what sort of people are needed? We have to identify and we have to recruit those people only. That means selecting the right person for the right job. And organizations can achieve its objectives only when it has the right person in the right position. Staffing is a process which includes acquisition, retention, development, performance appraisals, promotions, and compensation of the most important resource of an organization, and that is the human capital. Now, if you see in the picture on the screen, you can identify how the human resource planning is taking place. First, we are planning, then we are recruiting. In the planning, what we are doing, what sort of employees are in need for our organization. Then what we are doing, we are recruiting. After our recruitment, then we are selecting among recruitment who is the best one. Then after our selection, we are inducting and we are orienting. Then we are training and developing them. Then we are checking their performance appraisals. Then we are transferring to other departments. And at last, what we are saying? We are separating through retirement or death or dismissal. So this is the process of staffing. Now, we'll go with the next, which is directing. What do you mean by directing? It refers to the process of instructing or guiding or counseling, motivating and leading people in the organization to achieve its objectives. The process of directing involves guiding, coaching, instructing, motivating, leading the people in an organization to achieve organizational objectives. If you see here in the picture, a leader is leading and directing to his team. You have seen in your college days also, students, that a leader will be there. A faculty will make one leader for on behalf of all the students of the class. So what he will do? He will guide to other students. Next, controlling. Controlling is what? Controlling is a goal-oriented function which ensures that an organization's resources are being used effectively and efficiently for the achievement of predetermined goals. Now, what are the controlling? See, controlling means what? Totally controlling the organizations, either individuals or group of people. Either it can be an effectively or efficiently. Now, controlling process means what? Setting performance standards, measurements of actual performance, comparison of actual performance with standards, analyzing deviations, taking corrective actions. See, settling the performance, what is that? It includes how the performance should have to be set, and it is standard word or not. That means performance appraisal is taking place. We have to measure the performance, and we have to check out the comparison of actual performance with standards. What are the standards of an organization is having? Is it matching with that performance or not? Is if it is an extraordinary one, or it is up to the mark, if it is less one. Now, analyzing the deviation. Deviation means what? The action of departing from an established course or accepted standard. The action of departing from an established course. We have to analyze that and taking corrective action. If the employee is doing proper or is performing good in the organizations, okay, we have to motivate him, we have to make him, we have to show him. It is a duty of the leader who is organizing his team, who is leading his team, he should have to show his team that you have to go some more further in a proper way. If his performance is not matching, he should have to counsel him and he should have to guide him in such a way that he should have to correct his mistakes or errors. Now, if you see here, monitoring and controlling. See what is happening? These are the leaders who are monitoring and guiding them, and they are controlling to their subordinates or group or individuals. Why they are important? For achieving the common goal. The main work is a group of people, either employers or employees who are working. They are working to achieve a common goal. That means achieving the mission and vision of an organization. Now, coordination. See, after controlling, we have to go for the coordination. Coordination means what here? Coming together is a beginning, all together. Keeping together is a progress, and working together is success, by Henry Ford. He says, coordination means coordinating each other. This is very, very important in management skill. If your employees are not working, or if your subordinates are not up to the mark, it is a duty of the team leader. He should have to coordinate, he should have to motivate, he should have to show them with some examples, and he should have to work in a proper way. That means coming together, he should have to come down to that level. That will be the beginning. And he should have to keeping together, that is the progress. He should have to keep on saying him again and again, and he should have to, sometimes they have to show them in the field, they have to come down to the field and they have to do. This is nothing but the progress. And working together is a success. They have to, if any sort of mistakes are taking place with the boss or with the juniors, one, that means both parties should have to forgive that, and they have to come together and they have to work for coordination. Then only the achievement can be takes place. If you see this picture, you can understand. See, these three people are working together. They are coordinating to open the door of this room with heavy key. If anyone will not coordinate, they can't leave the other two people. If he miss this, this person is not coordinating, these two people can't handle that key. If the middle person is not coordinating, then it will be more weightage on these two. So all three people should have to coordinate, then only they can go out or they can achieve their common goal. Now see one more. I'll just tell you in common parlance what is the introduction or the meaning of coordination. The act or state of coordination or of being coordinated. People, order or relationship. The people should have to order or they have to maintain a relationship in such a way that harmonious combinations or interactions as of functions are part. That means whatever the things are taking place. If someone is not in a proper way, the other people should have to support him and they have to drag him to reach to his goal. If he is reaching to his goal, then it is a goal for the organization and the team leader. The credit goes to the boss. See in this picture, this person is not able to lift it and these two persons are helping him and guiding and coordinating with each other so that they can reach to their common goal. We'll go to the last one. This is decision making. Decision making is a process of making choices by identifying a decision, gathering information and assessing alternate resolutions. Using a step-by-step decisions making process can help you make more deliberate, thoughtful decisions by organizing the relevant information and defining alternatives. That is very, very important. That means in common parlance, choosing the right path. If you see in this picture, we are having, the employee is having five ways, which way he should have to go or which one he should have to select. What is happening? They have to select what is the time, what is his goal, what is the main oriented goal of the individual and the goal of the organization. When all together can meet, all these things they have to gather the information, they have to calculate and analyze it, and they have to take the proper step by step only. Now, these are the steps for taking the diamond proper decisions. First one is you have to recognize need for a decision. Then frame the problem. What is the problem? First, you have to recognize the problem. Before taking the decisions, you have to recognize the problem. Then you have to frame that problem. You have to, after identifying, you have to frame that. Yes, this is the main problem. Then you have to generate and access the alternatives. What is the alternative solution for this problem? You have to generate it and you have to assess that. That means you have to help. You can take. Then you have to choose among the alternatives. If you are finding 3 to 4 alternatives, you have to choose the best one. Then after choosing that, you have to implement that, choose an alternative and you have to work on it. And at last, you have to learn from the feedback. You should have to always take the feedback from your subordinates or from your elder ones. You should not have to feel shy. This is the management process. By taking out the feedback, you should have to correct yourself. So by this, we have completed our first topic in MOB, management and organizational behavior. Thank you, students. Have a nice day. Please mention your roll numbers in the, your names in the comment box. Thank you. Have a nice day.